Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. This is Siddhi Chauhan and you're watching me on For Women in India. Today we are going to discuss about the current situation of Hong Kong and how the new security law marks the rise of a new dawn of draconian suppression. On July 1, 2020, the rise of the dawn marked the birth of a new security law and an intense and political discourse in Hong Kong. The new legislation has been introduced by the Chinese parliament to establish a new security model in Hong Kong. Critics have argued that this could be used as a tool to suppress dissent and freedom of speech of individual. The draconian nature of the law can be assessed by the fact that the United Nations has called out the Chinese government for its ill-intentioned move, taking in consideration the number of arrests that have already taken place under the Act. The new law majorly contains provisions which categorically criminalizes political crimes such as secession, subversion, and collusion with foreign forces. What is alarming about this law is that the power to criminalize an individual rests with Beijing and not with the existing judicial authority of Hong Kong. And this does not come as a surprise that the legislation has been criticized for its aim to take away the autonomy of the political bodies and judicial bodies of Hong Kong over the land of Hong Kong. And the Chinese parliament is also planning to establish a national security commission in Hong Kong. And this move has been criticized for the involvement of Chinese government officials in the functioning and the constitution of Hong Kong. So the law basically empowers the Chinese parliament to define the crime, at the same time possesses the supreme authority to criminalize an individual without a shred of evidence. The law allows the Chinese government to monitor individuals on the basis of mere suspicion. The question that strikes here is, what purpose does labeling an individual as a terrorist without the charges have been proven serve? The answer is, this could have a detrimental impact on the individual's life as well as on his or her family's life. Also, surveillance of an individual who is considered or suspected to be a terrorist is also a violation of that individual's right to privacy, which is recognized as a basic human right under the Universal Declaration of Human Rights and almost all the countries throughout the world. And there are certain provisions in the Act which considers acts such as damage to public property as terrorist act. And considering the arrests that have already been permitted under the Act, this would not come as a surprise that the Chinese government would further exploit the Act to suppress any kind of dissent against its regime. Over 300 individuals have been booked under the law, most of whom are the individuals who were protesting against the legislation. Every such arrest is bound to become another nail in the coffin of the country's politics, which owes its existence to a long history of struggle and dissent against the colonizers. So that's it for today, and I hope you found this video informative. Share this video as much as possible, and we will meet next week. Thank you.